हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू ऑनलाइन स्टडी फॉर यू, वन स्टेप सॉल्यूशन फॉर ऑल योर प्लेसमेंट नीड्स। सो टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू डिस्कस टेक्निकल क्वेश्चंस व्हिच वर आस्क्ड इन स्लॉट वन ऑफ ऑन 25th October। वी आर डिस्कसिंग हियर TCS NQT एग्जामिनेशन क्वेश्चंस व्हिच वर आस्क्ड ऑन 25th October इन स्लॉट वन। सो विदाउट वेस्टिंग मच टाइम लेट्स मूव अहेड। Before starting with first question, I would like to tell you that we have also uploaded technical questions of slot 1 and 2 of 24th October. And as you know, the third slot was cancelled. So the previous two slots questions are also uploaded, so you can check. Okay, so in this question, as you can see, in a singly circular linked list, how many address fields are there? So even if it is singly circular linked list, how we can represent it like, okay, so we know that these are the nodes, right? And each having can be divided in two parts. We can call it one have data and other have the address. Which address? The address to next node, right? Similarly here and here also, but since it is singly linked list was circular one, then what will happen? Then this one means the address which will be here, the address, this will be pointing to the first node or the head node, whatever you can call. So even if it's not simple singly linked list, but simple singly circular linked list, still what we find that every node has only one address field, that is one address field every node. So here also it is trying to ask same thing, because it would have been doubly linked list, then we would have said two address fields, because then we have pointed to because in doubly linked list we know the pointers are that we can divide in three types, because the between one is we can call it data, and this is the address for the next node and this is for previous node. So here address fields would have called as two, but since it is singly linked list, even it is circular, still there will be only one address field, and we are talking about this as comparing with each node. Okay, so this is a very good question. Here we are asked select best suitable answer for below functions. The first one is size of functions, the other one is strlen functions. So these both functions are of C language. The size of function gives data size which that particular variable or the data is taking in memory, and strlen returns length of that string whichever is passed inside it. So firstly check that how it actually works. So suppose return somewhere hi u. Suppose this is written hi u, and there is a gap also between this. Okay, so this is a string. So here when we are asked about the length of a string, then we know that we will also count these spaces, right? So here the length of a string is 6. So whenever we will try to use this strlen on this hi u, which is having this space also, which I have, you can take it as underscore or dash also, no problem. So even if it would have been a space, still that space would be counted, even if it is in between or starting or at end, and the length of string will be not 5, actually 6. But when we will talk about size of functions, then notice there that every string has at the end a null function, a null value also, or you can call it simple as null, not as null value. So when the size will be calculated, then these 6 will be counted, plus this null will be also counted. So size will be character as data size as 6, means one character, one byte. So 6 bytes plus one, this null one, 7, right? So what we learned that when we are using the strlen functions, then we don't consider this null. But when we are working with the size of, then we consider this null, and the output will be 7 in that case, means 7, the size of 7 bytes. So here we have 4 options and we have to find that which one is correct. So if you start from D says a return size of string excluding null characters. This is right. No, this is wrong, because size of functions include null characters. So wrong. Now this size of return size of string including null characters, again wrong. No, this is right because size of, right. So size of return size of string including null characters, true. Str return size of string excluding null characters, yeah. So this one seems right, but we will go to other options also because we will check it which is most closely related with the correct answer. So this one says return size of a string excluding null character, size of, no. Return size of string including null characters, right? Return size of string including null characters in str len also, no. So correct output will be this C, okay, because in size of null character is included, but in str len it is not included. So correct output is option C. Now in this question, this is very important question because there are a lot of chance that you will do it in wrong way. Because what will you do? You will miss the important word written here and you will just read it. Okay, we have to construct a binary tree and these are the nodes given. We should make a binary tree. And then we will tell what is left child of 6. So what you will do, mistake. Firstly, I will do tell you that you will write like this 4. Then here is a 2. Here is a 1. Then you will do this. Right. This is what you will do in rush. And then when you will see the actual question, what will be this left child of 6? You will find that there is no left child of 6. And you will start thinking the question is not right and you will randomly select anyone because you will think since question is wrong, then I will be getting marks. But what wrong you have done, you have missed this word which is written pre-order sequence. Pre-order sequence means this is what given is, this is actually pre-order sequence. In pre-order sequence, as we learned in our previous video also, as and when we start traversing it from node to getting down and like this, right, I hope you remember, then what we do, like whichever arrives first, this is pre-order, whichever arrives first is noted down. It means 4 is arrived first, then 2, then 1, then 3. And since there are 7 nodes are here, it means this is clear that the height will be 2. Okay. So how actually it will be created, I will tell you 4. Then there would be 1, 2, and then 1, because we already know the height will be 2. Right, height is calculated. This is 0, this is 1, this is 2. Oh, sorry. I'm just raising it. Yeah. So 4, 2, 1, then this 3. Okay. Then this 6. Then this 5. And then 7. I will use a different color. So how you would traverse it in pre-order? 4. You can see the 4, this pre-order which now I will which will come will match with this one what is written in question. So 4 2 1 3, right, 6 5 7. So this is how it's actually required to be constructed, because if it would have been said that it is a binary tree, we would have done this. This is for sure. But it was given, pre-order sequence is given. So we have to create that tree that wise. And now the question is, what will be left child of 6? We can see here, we can see the left child, that is 5. So this question is solved now. Let's move to next question. So before moving ahead, I want to tell you here about some material which we have especially prepared for you guys so that you can do good in your test. So what you need to do only, you have to just search our YouTube channel name on Google, that is Online Study for You, and then going to the very first link.
Now friends, I will take you through the quiz contest. So friends, if you click on the quiz contest, then we have quiz here, click on that, and then you can see TCS NQT 2021 special quiz. So friends, we have free quiz and then we have paid quiz. So friends, paid quiz, for 10 quiz we have just put the price 49 rupees. So friends, first you take the free quiz, and if you like, because we have already included SDLC and decision making, all these kind of problems, so you can go through the free quiz and then you can go for the paid quiz. So 10 quiz will be available in the paid quiz. And friends, we have also released the TCS NQT crash course, and that is just for 249 rupees. So friends, in these 4-5 days, if you go through these courses, then there is a huge chance that you are going to crack the TCS examination like last year, where we had given more than 5000 results.
So in this question, it is asked that which of the following given operator is not a logical operator. Okay, so there is a mistake in this one. Here this one is actually exclamatory mark. So what we have to tell, that which of these following is not a logical operator. So this is logical not, this is logical and, this is logical or, but this one is bitwise and. So this is the one which is not a logical operator. So actually the correct answer would be this one. So these are, I have ticked only because these are logical operators. These are logical not and or, but this one is bitwise and, because it works on bit, not the numbers or whatever values passed. Also, I would like to tell you, if it is a single line, then it is an or operator, and if it's tilde, then it is bitwise and operator. Okay, so data modeling phase consists of which of following? Creation of logical data model, creation of infographics, creation of big data analysis model, or creation of evaluation tool. So here, firstly, we can do some odd one out. So here, creation of logical data model, so it seems might be the answer relative. Creation of infographics, no, cut it. Creation of big data analysis model, could be. Creation of evaluation tool, no, we are not working with verification or qualification, no testing here. So if you again go through the question, the data modeling phase. So here, it is the question related to database management system, and this can't be actually explain in any manner, because this is a straightforward answer for it, which is creation of logical data model is actually what is done in data modeling phase. This big data analysis model can't be actually termed as any phase, because this is additional, might be used or not used, but this is specific and definite that in data modeling phase, creation of logical data model is always there. Okay, so in this question we can see that the inheritance has been used here, and multiple inheritances here what we can notice. Okay, so what will be the output? So firstly we can see the main is here, so we will come here, void main car object. We are creating an object for this class Benz. So we are having for Benz. Benz is extending Mercedes, and Mercedes is extending car. So all these are related. Now with this object which we have created of Benz class, what we are calling? We are calling this show function. So in this Benz, let's go to this show. When we go to the Benz, there was not show function, but this is extending Mercedes class. So we will go to this Mercedes class now. Here we will see if any show function is there. Yes, it is there. And what it is saying? It's Mercedes. So the correct output will be it's Mercedes. Even if there was a show function was not there, then what would have happened? The control would have come here, and the output would have been brand is not defined yet. But here in this case, the correct output is it's Mercedes. This one which I have marked. Okay. So in this question, we can see we are asked what will be the output. It is not an MCQ type question, as we know that out of 10 questions, there are 2 or 3 questions which are fill in the blanks type. We have to type or write what the correct output would be. Okay, so here we can see that a try catch exception handling is also done. So what would happen, I will tell you. Here you can notice an array is given. We are starting from i0 going to array.length. This is completely fine. Whenever we have to traverse array, we start from 0 because an index starts from 0. And we traverse till the just one less than length of array. But here what we are doing, we are printing array index number, which means the float iteration number plus 1. problem what will happen is that initially what will be printed 0 plus 1 so means initially it will start from printing 25 because I 0 plus 1 becomes array 1 so 25 will be printed after this 2 then 6 then 8 similarly 9 7 and 32 okay after this what would happen that you can see here the range can be from 0 1 2 3 4 5 6 0 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 max can be 7 and here it is going till just less than array length is 8 it means I will become the last time in last iteration I will be 7 and here we will call array 8 because 7 plus 1 8 and array 8 there is no any element with index number array 8 at that point what will happen an exception will occur and output will be inside exceptions but the problem here is it is not clear what they are actually expecting our output to be because the actual output would be 25268973 inside exception it means this one plus this one but there are some thoughts also some people that output should be only inside exception the actual output would be this one which I have told you 25268973 inside exceptions in single line okay because we are using here print but it is not clear from TCS side also these type of problems are in many questions but even I cannot prefer you that would you go for these type of things that you write complete and then write this error or you simply write this error so this is a point of discussion and can this is only known by TCS that what they actually expect us to write only the exceptions that is inside exception or they want us to write this complete output okay so please comment down what you think what your thoughts are here or what you have discussed with your friends or faculties okay so here is a question which is for your homework I want you to discuss in the comment sections and as soon as I get starting some of right answers or someone or people getting near to the correct answer like just when I get 15 to 20 correct answers or people start discussing about it I will pin the correct answer in the comment box I've just used this because this question is quite complex and requires lots of discussion so that's why I want that you have a discussion with your friends or some other people on in our comment box also so that because this is something even if explained and won't be understandable at one time so what I want that you try to some search yourself have some discussion in our comment section and then surely I will be telling you output with the reason so this video ends here please subscribe to this channel and as I've told you please go to the previous two videos also of 24th October first and second slot because questions are not repeating but actually they are of same type understanding the type is same because like if you go for like in quants also in reasoning that decision making question is always coming that means question is same but thing is same right in quants also there are some questions which are regularly coming means the pattern is same questions are different so similar we are expecting and we have seen also in this round also some questions which are of previous type so please go to watch those videos also slot 1 and slot 2 the two different videos are there so I'm ending my video here if any queries please write in comment box yes please discuss about this question thank you